Hey, this is Swedish Guitar Nerd, and this video today is basically a follow-up to another video I did where I demoed a BC Rich Warlock. And what do I have in my knee today? Well, a BC Rich Warlock. So if you want to watch the first one, well, it's somewhere here. And yeah, the first one had lots of problems with the neck. It was my main complaint. I had a lot of complaints, but the main problems were with the neck. So I thought to myself, well, there are a lot of cheap BC Rich Warlocks with, you know, widow headstocks that are floating around. So why don't I buy another one and replace the necks? And it seemed like a really simple idea, didn't it? So yeah, that's what I did. I found this one. And this is, I'm not sure of what the model name is. These were sold in a pack, so you got a amplifier with it. I haven't even tried the amplifier. It's also red. It has these red bevels. But it's, yeah, it's in the cheapest range. You have the Metal Master, the Onyx series, the... what are they called? Yeah. All these super cheap, lowest price BC Riches, basically. Or similar to this one. It differs... yeah, let's talk about how it differs. Because, as I said, my idea was to get this one basically just for the neck. So, yeah, take the neck, throw away the rest of the guitar. But it wasn't really that easy. Because the neck on this one is like a baseball bat. It's not at all the same dimensions. Well, it's the same dimensions this way, and probably the fretboard is the same dimensions, but the back of the neck, well, it's really giant, and it reminds me a lot of the... I've done another BC Rich review, and there was a Mockingbird. And if you watch that one, you can watch that one. you could hear me talk about the neck on that one as well. That was really big. Really deep, that's the thing. It's really a thick neck. And it's the same with this one. So I couldn't replace the neck. But, yeah. I guess I have to keep it as it is. And it's better than the other Warlock. It's not good by any means, but it's better. Let's start at the top. And I will basically talk about the main difference is not so much about the guitar as I usually do. Well, we have the top, and I complain about the tuners on the other one. And the tuners on this one are really good. And you should mention that these are both made in China. And I think this is made some years later. I think the Mick Thompson was made, Thompson Warlock, was made in the early 2000s, and this is probably made in the late 2000s. So yeah, even though they're made in the same country and maybe even on the in the same factory, this has really good tuners. They are made in Korea, so they are really good. Not at all the ones that were on the other model. And as I said, the neck is so much thicker. It's I suppose it's Gibson specs. It's really thick. It's not at all. The other guitar, the Warlock, has a really slim neck. The frets on this one is they are better placed. They are better. I don't know. Feels like they had made a slightly more effort of making this good, but no, it's not even at all. You have uneven frets, and it starts. It's okay. I mean, up to the 12th fret, but then down here it gets worse and worse. So you have notes just dying out, and yeah, they are uneven. Some are higher, some are lower. It's not very good. The body is on this one made of agathis. Well, if you find cheap guitars, well, it's basswood or it's agathis. And this is agathis. It's much heavier than the other one. And then it's not thicker at all, the body. Good or bad? I'd say it's bad. The thing is, it's dense and it's more solid, probably. It has the same kind of bridge that the other one does, but it's slightly, you can tell it's slightly better quality. But like the other one, this is tilting as well. You know, like the strings are pulling it towards the neck. But since the agathis seems to be hardwood, it's not that big of an angle. I don't know, can someone comment if you have the PRS guitars? Because they are the main contenders that have these kind of bridges where it's like just two posts and not a separate. The tunematics, you really have like one thing here and one thing here where it's anchored. And I don't think you have that problem with those. But do you have those problems with the PRS bridge as well? Are they tilting? I don't know. The top on this one has bevels, as you can tell, and that's the main thing. I think it's basically sold as the red bevel BC Rich guitar, and it makes a difference. Because playing wise, when especially with me that plays with my entire arm, it's so much nicer to not have a super square edge here, because you hit it all the time. So this is much better. Yeah, it looks nice. The finish on this one compared to the other one is, they can't be compared. This is much better. This is very good. So it's, yeah, night and day, basically. Pickups on this one are the regular that you find on all cheap BC Riches from this period, the BDSMs. And they're really good. I'll play some so you can hear them. But I like these pickups. Electronics wise, well, as you've seen, I removed the tone knob, and yeah, it had the usual problem with so many of the guitars I review, that it's not really working. You get nothing and then you get too much. So I just removed it. But the volume knob works great, and the three-way switch as well. So yeah. And it's very interesting. I must say this. It's interesting because I think these are made in the same factory that makes Epiphone guitars, for instance. Certainly the pickups are made by the same company that makes the pickups in the Epiphone guitars. And you wonder, why are the pickups in Epiphone guitars so much worse? Because these pickups are really good. Why don't they put these in the Epiphone guitars? The electronics are made by the same company that, for instance, PRS Epiphone are using. So this is what you find in Far Eastern guitars, basically. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So yeah, I'm going to play some for you now. And for a change, I'm in my rehearsal space. So I'm going to play you something with a real amplifier and on full volume. So that's a new thing, actually. It's my first demo with full volume. So yeah, first the clean sound. And then I'm gonna do some high gain and delay, as I usually do. Okay, so there you have it. I forgot to mention one thing about the bridge. In this one, it's actually in the right place. Because in the Mick Thomson one, I had to adjust it further down. So this needs no adjustment. I even removed the ugly screws. It's the same ugly screws. Just remove them, because it's in the right place. So it seems to be a better guitar. But the problem still, the neck. Same problem. So I don't know. Is this a Chinese guitar problem? Maybe it is. Well, this has been the Swedish Guitar Nerd in part two, basically, of my B-Series Warlock demo. So this is another version of a cheap B-Series Warlock. Hope you found this useful. See you soon.